Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear webinars, in our previous class we had solved exercise number 1, that is al-murakkab al-idafi. Write the two parts of al-murakkab al-idafi with examples. This we had solved in our last class. Today we are proceeding towards exercise number 2, which is ayyin al-murakkab al-idafi, which means identify possessive phrase. First exercise we have done in our last class carries 4 marks, that is also a compulsory question in your final exam. Today the exercise which we are solving, this is also a compulsory question in your final exam. He will ask you to identify possessive phrase in the following sentences. He will give you the sentences and ask you to identify, extract possessive phrase and write it down in your answer sheet. So how to identify possessive phrase, we will discuss this in this exercise. What is our previous class? In our previous class we solved the two parts of possessive phrase with examples. What are the two parts of possessive phrase? First we have taken al-murakkab al-izafi, then the name of the first part al-muzafu, then the name of the second part al-muzafu ilayhi, then we gave the heading al-amthilatu, then we wrote 3 examples: Kitabullahi, Baitullahi, Rasulullahi. That was exercise 1. Now we are solving exercise number 2. Here it is: Ayyin al-murakkab al-idafi. Identify possessive phrase. He will give you the sentence: Hada kitabu Hamid. This is Hamid's books. How to identify possessive phrase in the given sentence? The guess is to, the hint is, find 2 nouns one beside the other. First you have to find 2 nouns in the phrase. As you know that a possessive phrase is a noun phrase, then observe that the first noun must not contain alif lam in the beginning. Then observe the first noun must not contain al in the beginning, because al muzafu does not take al in the beginning, and it also does not take nunation at the end. This is also a rule. And try to observe that the second noun may have al or may not have al. If the al is not there, then it will be a name of a person. So here the name of a person is given. So kitabu hamid, and as you know that the second noun al muzafu ilayhi is always in genitive case, means it carries at the end of the word 1 kasra or 2 kasras. So hada kitabu hamid, now we can identify that kitabu hamid is possessive phrase. We will write in the answer sheet, then we will write, give underscore, then we will write al murakkab al izafi. This is the way to answer the question. Now come to second sentence. Sayyaratul mudiri min al yaban. What is possessive phrase in this sentence? Sayyaratul mudir is possessive phrase in this sentence. Now come to baitut tajir amam al masjid. So in this sentence baitut tajir is possessive phrase, as we have written it. Ma huwa fi wasatil maidan. What is there in the middle of the garden, middle of the ground? Here the translation of Sayyaratul Mudir min al-Yaban is the principal's car is from Japan. The car of the principal is from Japan. And the translation of Baitut Tajir amam al-Masjid is the house of trader is in front of Masjid. The house of trader means businessman. Ma huwa fi wasatil maidan. Wasatil maidan is al-murakkab al-izafi, possessive phrase. It means what is there in the middle of the ground. Last sentence is hada qalamul mudarris. This is teacher's pen or the pen of teacher. So qalamul mudarris is possessive phrase. We will write qalamul mudarris in the answer, then we will write al murakkab al izafi. This is your exercise 2. We are winding up our class. Inshallah, in our next class we will do exercise number 3. Thank you for listening. Assalamu alaikum.